Hello everyone, a warm welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start with the chapter of the legislature. As you can see on my screen, it is written legislature. So what exactly are we going to do? First of all, in order to study a topic properly, we need to have a mind map. So what is that mind map? I will tell you in a while. What are the things that are we going to do today? It's already written in the comment section, but still I want to give you an idea. First, we are going to do what is exactly a government and from where legislature was established. Functions and roles of the legislature and structure of legislature. The decline in the role of the legislatures in modern times and the reasons behind such a decline. We are also going to discuss exclusively the legislature in India and US, France, and we will compare them. We are going to discuss the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and we are going to do the position of Lok Sabha in each country, how powerful it is. Then the lower house, then the second house of the Rajya Sabha. So we will do a comparative analysis of both these houses. We are also going to talk about the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, namely the House of Representatives and the Senate in the US. We are going to do a detailed study as we do in case of India. So watch till the end. Today we are going to divide the video into 30 minutes part so that the video doesn't become a huge morbid for you, so that you can grasp the concepts easily. Otherwise it will take a lot of time to cover this chapter, so we have divided it for your benefit. I hope you will agree with the division. Now first, what is legislature? Before we come to that, we know that the legislature is a part of the government. It is a third wing, or it is one of the three wings of the government. So what is a government? For example, you take Aristotle said that the function of the state is to promote happiness among the people. That is the concept of the welfare state. Now what is exactly a state? State is a comprising of three main features: population, sovereignty, the land area, and international recognition. So international recognition, this point may be new to you, because you see, each country, one of India being one of the 187 countries, sovereign countries means the countries which have control over both their external and internal matters. Now what are the internal matters? It is education, law and order, and it is agriculture and other sectors. And it is definitely a part of a foreign policy to increase the foreign direct investment too, but that is in the case of the foreign policy. So what exactly is the government doing? Now the government is a body which formulates, expresses and enforces the will of the people, will of the state. Here the state refers to people, because in a democratic country, this legislature helps in the formulation of laws. Mainly there are three wings of the government who formulates the will of the people. Means you see, in a particular area, people elect their own representatives, so they are the will of the people, the majority will of the people. And there are some representations, the minority opinion and dissent, right to dissent is also agreeable in a parliament or a legislature. Now who expresses the will of the state? It is expressed, that means it is executed by our executives, who are the law implementing agencies. And who enforces the will of the state? Enforces the will of the state is the judiciary, because the judiciary adjudicates the various disputes based on these laws that are made by the parliament, that are made by the lawmaking bodies. And these lawmaking bodies are the legislature. So you can understand a direct connection between legislature and the government. It is one of the part of the government. Okay, now we come to a part of this. you can see this slide, I hope. So this slide is mainly because you see there is a circle. This is the legislature, which is the representation of the people, and this is the state. State is always bigger than this because see, state comprises four elements, and they are territory, sovereignty, population, international recognition. So there are mainly four, and there are many other which are being added because the concept of state is always evolving in nature. But it needs to have sovereignty. This is the main factor. And so the state is the whole thing. And here within the state are what? This population. This is the people. Population. And this executive forms the core because people elect them. Not the whole of the population is a part of the executive. We are indirectly or directly the lawmaking part of our country. Now the executive is divided into executive is the law. Make law implementing body. Laws are made by whom? Laws are made by the parliament, and this are implemented by the executive. And executive, you see, in your town, if you consider in your town, who takes the developmental manage or issues of regarding that? There is a panchayat, or there is a lower level of municipality or anything. So they manage your day-to-day activities. It is not possible for the executive to always come and manage it. So there are ministers in each state, so they manage it, they make the what. So ours is a federal system, you have to remember. Federal means division of powers is there. So in order to make division of powers, we need to divide it in this way. See, it is political executives, the ministers we elect, and these are the cabinet ministers who actually implement those laws. And this is the bureaucracy, you know, civil servants in various districts. We see the IAS officers or the IPS officers, they implement the things. They are an important factor here. The IPS, you have seen that this IPS has helped this area, he has done this, he has done that. Because to reach the people, you need IPS, IAS and other rank officials, and they are a part of the Indian administrative system. They are too a part of executive, because you see, the ministers are not, by executive we don't mean only the minister, we also mean the bureaucracy. This has to be kept in mind and can be an important question. Now the government is there, and government in how many parts it is divided? Government is divided into legislature, executive and judiciary. Now see, there are different parts it is given. So this is total altogether, this is a government. It is divided into three parts, that is judiciary, and this is legislature. So this is whole of the government. All the people don't form the government. See, this is our state, and in state we elect people who make laws, one implement those, and one adjudicates the disputes. Now if there are laws, there will be some problems regarding it, there will be cases coming up. So there we need an independent body which would give justice to the people. So we need that, and that's why we have the significance of this judiciary. Now there is a different chapter on judiciary, this executive and judiciary. Today we will focus on the legislature, and these are representatives of the people. They are directly elected by the people, especially in our country India, and we will discuss it further. Now what is a government? So government is the will of the state, I have told you. Law implementation, law making functions, I have told you by which bodies they are done. Now to give you a back story in the state, what was state previously? Previously the kings and the queens used to rule a particular area. So they used to rule, the assembly was there, the assembly of that time, those areas, those assemblies where you can compare it with modern legislature. Now the king everything dependent upon the whims of the king. He was despotic, and there was this divine origin theory. People accepted him as the messenger of God or anything such as. But after the revolutionary theory, there came a change. So it was divided here, and it was thought that people will be given democracy, or people's right will be taken care of. So this legislature was established. Now the assembly was a king's compartment. It depended on the king's wishes. Now judiciary was also dependent, because in those days injustice was the main reason. There were many injustice in the people, because it depended on the interest of the king only, not the interest of the country. So here, if we keep the interest of the state or the country, then we will need legislation. I hope you could understand. Now so in those days it was the situation. Now in today, modern day, we have the legislature. So supposedly a law is made in the parliament, and we know who makes the law. This is the legislature which makes the law. Now it makes the law. So lawmaking process, now if you make a law, you have to implement it. How will you implement? Implement means you have to execute the law. So you will execute by the executive body, and then comes the if anybody transgresses any law, transgresses means breaks any rules or regulation, there is always judiciary who will look into the case. They will solve the case. We have a different chapter on it. They do law adjudication process. Which laws? Laws that are made by the parliament. The laws are, and there are different sources of laws. Our constitution is a source of law. So there are different sources of law. It is not like that each day a new law is created. Obviously, in unwritten constitution that is happening, that is a different case, we'll discuss it. And now, what is the meaning of legislature? So you could understand. And legislature, if you say, it is a house of discussions. It discusses the what is good for our country, good for the people, because they are elected by the people. If they keep on doing despotic activities, they will not be elected the next time. No election of this to remain in power. So the politics is nothing but a struggle for power. To remain in power, they have to implement laws for the benefit of the people. Some may infringe the fundamental rights, but always you have to consider the greater good. In this case, the greater good. Okay, now legislature has been derived from the word lege, L-E-G-G, lege, which means leisure. So you can remember it this way, L-L, lege of our country is the legislature. So it is, it means the leisure. Leisure means what? Place. It means place. Place of what? Place of discussion, place of debate, place of talk, as you say. Place of talk, or legislature is a place of the talk. Deliberations are held, compromises are held. Okay, now in the absence of a legislature, if there is no legislature and we always depend upon one ruler, he becomes despotic, because in the legislature we elect our representatives. They go, so they give the will of the people or the greater good, as I have said. But a despotic ruler doesn't know, and through this legislature only the will of the state is represented. So we need legislatures, and otherwise the state may become totalitarian in nature. We'll discuss the features in the next session. And so this is all about legislature. You can see a chart is given in the screen. This chart is, you can see, as I have told you, state is a sovereign. So you know what is the meaning of sovereign. Sovereign is externally and internally free individual, free country. That means its leaders are free to decide what policies they will do externally, internally, and no country will interfere in their matters. Obviously not, now otherwise it will infringe our area. or it will infringe our security. Okay, now we have told you that the legislature formulates the laws. Lawmaking function, you can see this from the screen, you can pause it and read it, it's just for your benefit. Now, what are the functions of legislature? So, I have told why it was constituted. So, what is a function? You see in a democracy, how can we term a country as democrat? When the will of the people is there, the people's will has been taken into account while framing the policies of our country. So, first, it has the lawmaking functions. You can see this first point, lawmaking functions. So what is lawmaking? Now previously I said laws has many sources, so we will discuss it in a separate session, but you know the most important source of law is nothing but the legislature in modern times. The legislature, you know, no need of dwelling on old custom, definitely they play an important role, but not more role than the legislature. It is the legislature which formulates the will of the state into laws and vests this with legality and legitimacy. And legislature processes the demands of the people into statutes. Now what are statutes? Statutes are the laws made by the parliament. It's a simple definition. And these are known as statutory laws. Next is the deliberative functions. The deliberative functions is this, and this deliberative functions means that see this in US a famous political scientist, he said that Congress of opinions, because you see Congress is their lower house, so all laws are done by the Congress there. So in India it is done by the Lok Sabha or the parliament, you can say. But so he called this Congress of opinions. Why opinions? Because they were particularly interested in the area of solving the grievances of the people, taking care of their nation in particular. Now this deliberative actions means there are deliberations, there are discussions, there are discussions of the policies, discussions about what? For the good of the country, making laws for the country to maintain a good proper law and order in the country. So they make laws, they take various policies and decisions are implemented, so they are adopted for the national interest. Now that's why we need sovereignty, so keep our national interest in a secure manner. So we have done the deliberative functions, means discussions are done on this. Now custodian of the national finances. Now we all pay taxes. The government has both the things, expenditure and earning. Now expenditure is for the development of the country, and earning, how it is done? It is done through taxes, various taxes, property tax, industrial tax, road tax, transport tax, anything you can say, everything, there is a cess or a tax. Now we have the GST in India, and this is an example. Now this money of the people, so this is the money of the people. You can see the people are mostly all the people, some there are some tax evaders, but we are not considering them. So money of the people is utilized for the development of the country, and this is democracy. Now this money, who comes into the play here? Consolidated Fund of India, from where the salaries of various persons are paid. Now for legislative, the ministers, you can say the judiciary, this all people who are working, their salaries are paid, they are given money to do developmental works in their own area. So there is always in the new year there are budget. In India we have three budget sessions, we will discuss this in the next sessions, but we have a budget. Now budget is expenditure and earning, there should be a balance. For example, in your family, if you don't have balance between your earning and expenditure, the whole finance system of your home will break down. And home is nothing but household. Household means a unit, and it makes a society, and later it makes a country. So we have for the greater coordination, we have the legislation who takes care of this. Now, no money can be sent without the adherence or without the knowledge of the legislature. It has to be approved by the legislature for what purpose the ministers are taking money, or for what developmental work will this money be used. So this is a main point, and they keep different committees to delve into an inquiry. Supposedly a minister has taken so much amount of money, but he is not returning or could not show where he has used this. And there are different committees, like the public accounts committees, who will just verify where the money has been used. This is called accountability. You have to be accountable for the people's money. If there is secrecy in it, we will not call it democracy. We need accountability in our country. We have to show the people for their tax money how it is allocated in the budget. Now, second is the control over the executive. Executive is a part of the parliament, and they are the majority who has got the majority vote. They are the part of this parliament, so part of this cabinet is called kitchen cabinet too. There are mainly many divisions. 15 members are there as kitchen cabinet, and 60 other members are there also working outside the cabinets. They have been given different ministries, for example finance ministry, then Indian railways, water supply, education minister. I've heard this. So they are part of the cabinet. They take the money to do things. So they have to be responsible. When supposedly your mother gives you some money, and she asks you where have you spent it, and you don't know where you have spent it, or you have done some mischief, so-called, you will have to be responsible for your own money. So this legislature also controls the executive, controls how the executive is spending the money, and each member of the executive collectively and individually have to be responsible. And if they are not responsible, what will happen? Who will take the charge? Who will suffer from it? There will be a vote of no confidence. So parliament will show that we have no confidence on the elected cabinet that we have, and the Sabha, Lok Sabha in India, will dissolve. And Lok Sabha is the part of the parliament, or this is the legislature or lawmaking body. So this will be dissolved. So they put in check and balances, and there can be many types of motions which we discuss. And there are many types of motions, and there are many committees that are instituted to look into the particular issues of this, of the budget that has been given, the money that has been allocated. So to prevent the nation from suffering at the hands of the executive. Now, the control over presidential executive. Now, in the presidential form of government in USA, there is a separation of powers of the legislature and the executive. We too have that in our country, and each is powerful in its own sphere of activity. Now, federal government means, we'll discuss it, but an idea, it means division of powers in a country between the state governments and the national government. State governments means the in each state. For example, state government of West Bengal, and union government, what the government in power at the center, who takes care of the foreign policies of India and the foreign dealings of India, foreign matters, and the matters of national importance are taken care of by the union government. But the matters that are provincial in nature that are taken care by the state. So there is a division of powers. It works effectively. It has some pros and cons, which we discuss in the next sessions. And so there is, so what is the presidential election here? The legislature exercises some control over the executive, as we have seen. It appoints investigation committees to check the functioning of the government, to pass the budget, you know, to pass the budget, how much money is allocated. So it, the legislature checks them already. So performance is also a very important factor. If the executive is not performing well in implementing the laws, then there will be a bad impression on the people of the legislature. And so in this way it checks this. And in presidential executive there is a different thing, and we do not have the presidential executive in presidential executive, or the president has many powers. In our country, president is the nominal head. Now comes the constituent functions or amendment of the constitution. Now how to amend the constitution? Ours in India, it is a very lengthy constitution, because everything has been incorporated in it. Provisions are very helpful, and this, so ours is a written constitution, and we have directions to conquer any situation. So it is very helpful, and it can be changed. And this changing of the constitution, some parts of the constitutions are difficult to change and some are easy to change. So Indian state is a mixture of flexibility and rigidity. So we are a quasi-federal nation. We both have the I am talking about India. We both have the unitary form of government and federal form of government. Okay, so in order to amend the constitution, we have to pass 2/3 of the absolute majority of votes in both the houses. And again, if it's a difficult part of the constitution, it needs ratification by the state legislature. How it is done, we will discuss definitely. And so it is approved by the people indeed. Now comes the electoral functions. You know that we elect our legislature. People elect the legislature in their own country directly. Elections are done, so the parliament can change the rules and regulations of the elections too. And in Switzerland, for example, the federal assembly elects the members of the Switzerland. My handwriting is very bad, sorry. And federal assembly elects the people of federal council and federal tribunal. And in the US system, election of the president is done. You know, it's not possible for a person to have an absolute majority of votes. No. So it is done that a few candidates are chosen in ranks and positions, and the best candidates who has got the majority of the polls is given the presidential seat. I'm talking about USA. Now in India too, it is done. We directly elect the members of the legislature, executive, and the legislative assemblies, as you say in India. There are many elections, so it controls the elections in a way. And this election, through these elections only, the legislature is constituted. And in this legislature, we have the electoral college, which elects the president. So we have seen now this presidential executive function. So we it controls this in this way, because the electoral college, the members are a part of this legislature. So we indirectly elect our president in India. Now comes the judicial functions. The judicial functions, it is not written here. I'm adding judicial functions. And what is you see that the legislature acts as an investigating court and trying high public officials on charges of treason and high crimes. For example, in American political system, the Congress has the power of impeachment. This is called impeachment, removing a member of the executive or the legislature by two-third majority. In different countries have different rules and regulations regarding impeachment. Why it is impeachment is done? Because if a person proves incapable of his or her position, then they will not be able to function properly. And on the functioning of the legislature, you can see so many functions are there. And if these are like in a bad situation, then we will not get good results. Okay, so we need that. Now comes the by a two-third majority, we need resolutions in our country to in the legislature to remove the members, and it can be of the Supreme Court and also the High Court as far as India is concerned. And as far as the US is concerned, the US House of Representatives, it is just like our Lok Sabha in India. And this is the legislature of US, the House of Representatives. In India we name it the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, and this is the House of Representatives, and there is something called this Senate is there. These are members of the cabinet. I hope you remember what the cabinet means, the executive part in our country India, and in US it is called the Senate. So they too have the control over the executive branch, so they can remove anybody. Now the ventilation of the another function is the ventilation of grievances. Ventilation of grievances. Now what is grievances? Grievances means a problem or a trouble. Now if in a legislature, as we say, it is a Congress of opinions, there are different types of aspirations and opinions and grievances of the people are done. As you know, the legislature is a part of the deliberations in the country, and where there are parliamentary debates and they throw light on different important topics. There are different committees that are playing this role, and the implementation, you know, before the elections different parties, political parties say that we will do this and that, when we come to power you give us vote, so they take our votes. Now the election manifesto that they show, this election manifesto consists of their policies when they come to power. So they had already decided and make minor changes. The majority, if we say, who wins now, they always people's wishes are just implemented, and if people vote, majority of people vote for a particular political party, so that means the will of the nation is also shown in this way. And there are so what do they do after coming to power? They implement the promises that had been held out before the elections. Now there are many, so we have done almost all the functions, and there are so ventilation of public grievances. Now the legislature is a part of this. These are directly elected by the people, so our people, they are not like any other people from different branch. They are our people who are going and telling our problems, our aspirations, and they are being implemented. So legislature does that functions of expressing the will of the nation. And there are different miscellaneous functions. For example, the Lok Sabha has more powers than the Rajya. We will discuss how it is. The Rajya Sabha can start an all India service by a resolution of two-third majority. It can also provide a scope for the union government to establish laws if they feel that any particular subject is of national importance. There are many lists, union lists. We will discuss them very easily. Now legislature, we know. To conclude, legislature is the legal sovereign. Because our country is an independent country, people have to be given the space to talk, to solve their aspirations, goals of the nations, okay? And they are representative of public opinion because they are directly elected by the people. And now it also expresses the popular mind and conscientious opinion of the people. And through political education is required while you choose an representative from your constituency. And for political to choose a leader, you have to see how the leader is accountable, what are the ethics of the leaders, what are the morality. You have to take in this, and these things comprise in the political education. If you politically educate the people, they will choose the right person, and it will definitely lead to the betterment of our country. So this is all about today's topic. Now I hope that you found this video helpful, and if you found this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe our channel for more updates. Now in the next session, we are going to start off with the structure of legislation. Thank you for watching.